Good morning. It's going to be another beautiful day, but we're going to have to contend with the wind today. Temperature-wise, very mild this morning. Upper 50s as we head through the 9 o'clock hour. We'll climb into the upper 60s by noon and even a couple of degrees warmer than yesterday. We're going to top out in the low 80s this afternoon with overall partly cloudy skies today. Winds right now, not too bad, but again, they are going to get stronger as we head through the day, especially up in the northeast and the east central plains. Right now at about 5 to 10 miles per hour, but they will be southwesterly today at 15 to 25 miles per hour for the metro, gusting up to 30 miles per hour, but we're going to see 25 mile per hour sustained wind up in the northeast, and then we're going to see those gusts approach 45 miles per hour. And with dry air being pushed in, we're going to see extremely dry conditions today, so red flag warnings in effect. We're going to see that high risk of fire danger for much of the state today. Temps this morning, mid to upper 40s up to the north, low 40s in Clayton, 48 in Clovis. We're in the low 60s right now in the metro and starting off in the mid 50s in the southwest. It's going to be another warm one, especially out east, 10 to 15 degrees warmer.
All right, Kristen, thank you. Here now is your Thursday morning news blitz. Three Afghan police were killed and six others were wounded when a concealed bomb detonated inside of their van at a police training base. The wounded include children who were near the blast site. In South Korea, anti-nuclear protesters rallied to denounce nuclear developments around the world and mark Earth Day amid Japan's nuclear crisis. Tomorrow is the 41st anniversary of Earth Day. A Bernalillo officer was freed after being arrested for DWI. Officer Jose Berto Chavez was not booked into the Metro Detention Center, citing possible danger to himself by other inmates. A wanted sex offender from Oregon was caught in Los Alamos yesterday. Bruce Krauser was convicted in 2001 of sexually assaulting three teenage girls and was wanted for failing to register in 2009. That does it for your Thursday morning headlines.